Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to cover week four of our VBA series. In this case, we are going to divide up some data in Excel by category, and we're going to put a total on how many questions are in each one of those categories. And we are going to do this by using the offset function we have actually covered in a previous video, where we're using offset as a function inside of Excel, but this time we are going to use it in VBA. We're also going to go over how to use a combination of keys on the keyboard in order to run a macro instead of using a button like we did last week. So let's go over our spreadsheet. This week, I have a series of questions for a Seinfeld trivia game, and I have them divided up in categories. At the top, I have the six different categories, and I have frozen the panes of my window so that I can scroll down through my questions and the top doesn't move. So first of all, I have category one questions, which are for characters, and then I have category two questions, three, four, five, and six. And then I have a space down here to write new questions. So if you look, you will see that when one category ends, the second category begins. So that is going to take a sorting function. And we are going to do that first in our macro. Secondly, to the left, you will see that I have a counter. And that counter is counting how many I have of each category. So right now, I have 22 questions for category one. And if I click in there, you will see a formula. And that formula is saying, if whatever I have in B33 is not equal to what I have in B32, then I want to start the count all over again by putting a 1. Otherwise, I just want to add 1 to the cell before it because that means that the category is the same. So when I click on the cell for this 1 here, where the formula actually changes, you can see that if I go back to cell B34, that is not equal to B33. So I'm going to put a 1 in here in this case instead of adding 1 to the previous record above it. So if I scroll down and I put a category 1 question here and I just type in question 1, answer 1, you will see that this is out of order. And if I put a question 2 and an answer 2, that is also out of order. So the first thing I want to do with my data is to sort all of this by category. So how do I do that? If I go up to cell B12, this is where I would like to begin my sort. So I'm going to record a macro by clicking on macros and going to record macro. And I'm going to call this sort and recalculate. And I'm going to say okay. And then I'm going to select my cells from B12 all the way over to D12 because that's where my questions begin. And I'm going to scroll all the way down and further, anticipating that I'm going to get many more questions in the future. So about 250 rows should do it. And then I'm going to go up to the data tab. And I'm going to hit sort and I'm going to say okay. Now if I go back to the view tab and I click on macros and I say stop recording, now I have sorted all of my data. So let's see what that looks like. If I scroll to the bottom of my ones, you will see I now have question one here and I now have 23 questions. Up here it says 22, but we need to update that to 23 because I added a question. And if I scroll down past the twos, you will see that I have question two here and I have 17 for category two, but up here I still only have 16. So I would like to update this number. And the way that I get to that number is I start on cell B12 and I see what number I have in there. And I have a 1 and I keep moving down one cell over and over again until I come to a 2. So that is going to be a loop of moving down one cell over and over and over again until I come to a different value. Same thing for the two questions. Once I'm on 2, if I keep moving down, I will see that I change from 2 to 3. So I will want to give this new count when I change from 2 to 3. And then when I go through all the 3s, I will want to give this new count until I get all the way through the 6s. And then I would like to update these numbers up here. So that's going to be the rest of my macro. So let's see what that recorded macro did for us already. If I go to macros and I go to view macros, I can go to sort and recalculate and hit edit. So right here, I can see that my range has been selected and any previous sorts have been cleared out. And then I'm going to go for an ascending sort and I'm going to apply that sort. So now that I know that my sorting is working, I would like to start cycling through each one of those cells until I get to the end of category one and see what my new total is. In order to do that, I'm going to need a few variables. I'm going to take out the title of this macro, and then I'm going to declare a few variables. My first variable is the current category. So I'm going to say dim current category as, and I'm just going to use a string right here. And then I'm also going to have to keep track of what cell I'm on. So I'm going to dim RNG current cell as range, because that will tell me where I am currently and what the value of that cell is and whether or not that cell is changing. So this is actually a really fun loop to keep looping through here. So down here, after the end width, I'm going to hit enter a few times and start coding for my loop. So first of all, I want to select cell B12, because if I go back to my spreadsheet, you will see in cell B12, this is where my category count begins. And for now, I'm just going to loop down until this number changes, because I would like to show you how to do that. So I'm going to Alt-Tab back to my VBA code, and I'm going to set my current category equal to range B12.value. So first, I want to set my range of my cell equal to B12, because that's where I'm starting. It's going to keep changing. So I'm going to use the word set RNG current cell equal to range B12 and hit enter. And then I'm going to do a do until loop. So what I would like to do is I would like to keep moving down cell by cell until the cell that I'm in does not match the current cat number that I have set above. So how do I write that? Do until current cat does not equal, which is a less than sign and a greater than sign, RNG current cell dot value. So right now my current cell is set to B12, but for every time I move down from B12, I want to change the location of that cell. So I'm going to set RNG current cell equal to RNG current cell dot offset. And the offset function allows the cell to move down or to move across. So watch what happens when I put a left parenthesis in. I can either have a row offset or a column offset or both. So in my case, going back here, I'm moving down. So what I would like to do is have a row offset of 1 and put in a comma, and then have a column offset of 0 because I don't want to move to the right. So I'm going to close my parentheses, hit enter, and do a loop. And I want to keep looping through until those values are not equal. Then I'm going to do RNG current cell dot select so that you can see where I am on my spreadsheet. Okay, so in summary, I'm going to start at cell B12, and then I'm going to keep going down one cell until the value that I've stored from B12 is no longer equal to the value in my current cell. So let's run this. I'm going to hit Alt-Tab to go back to Excel. And I'm going to go to macros and go to view macros, hit sort and recalculate, and hit run. And you can see that Excel has in fact selected B35. And if you look, that is what I want because this is where the cell value has changed. So now that I'm at this point, I have found the change between my numbers. So I would like to do a few things here. The category now needs to be updated to a 2, and this value up here in cell A4 needs to be the value in this cell over here, which is up 1 and over 1 to the left. So hopefully you can see that I will be using the offset here. So there's two things I would like to do. Update the count at the top and change my category to a 2. So I'm going to Alt-Tab back to my code. I'm going to set the current category equal to my current cell dot value. And then I'm also going to Alt-Tab back to Excel, look in cell A4, and that is the value that I wish to update. So I am going to do range A4 equals RNG current cell dot offset. And remember, I wanted to go up 1, which is a negative because the default is to go down, comma, and then 1 to the left, which is also a negative 1 because going to the right is a positive number. And I'm going to hit enter. So let's run this code now. I'm going to Alt-Tab back to Excel, go to macros, go to view macros, and run sort and recalculate. First of all, I want you to look here and see that the value in A4 is currently 22, but it needs to be updated to 23. So I'm going to hit run, and you will see that my code did run, and it did update that number correctly. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So it's going to be the same thing 6 times. So I'm going to Alt-Tab back to my VBA code. The key word that I said there is the same thing 6 times. So what I'm going to do is look through my code a little bit more right here. What do I need to keep and what do I need not to keep? I will need to change my current category, which I already did, and I will need a different cell right here to set to that offset value because I will be on a new category. If I select just this code right here and I hit Control C for copy, and then I click down here and Control V to paste, I can start the whole process all over again. But let me go back to my Excel spreadsheet by hitting Alt Tab. And this time you will see that I want the total for category 2 to be in cell A5 instead of A6. So I'm going to Alt Tab back to my code and change this to A5. So let's see what happens when we run that. What should happen is I should be on 3, and this number here should be updated to 17. So I'm going to go to macros, sort and recalculate, and hit run. And you can see this remained at 23, and this is now 17, so it is correct. So now I'm on category 3. And if you look, I have 4 more categories up here that I would like to update. And if I Alt Tab back to my code, I'm going to again copy this code, hit Control C, go to the end of my code, hit Enter, and paste that in. And this time I'm just going to go to A6. But at this point, you can tell that I really should be using a loop, because all I'm doing is this same exact code from here to here over and over again. And the only thing that's changing is this number. And look, it's incrementing by 1. So let's go up top and declare a variable, dim int counter as integer. When I declare an integer, it starts at the value 0. Let's set that counter down here equal to 4, because cell A4 is where I'm beginning. And we can really simplify this code and not have to type it in over and over again. So here I'm going to go do until int counter equals, and I'm going to Alt Tab back to my spreadsheet and see that row 9 is where I would like to end this. I'm going to Alt Tab back to my code, and I'm just going to say I'm going to do this until it equals 10, because once it does equal 10, I don't wish to execute this code anymore. And I'm going to go down here to the end of the code that I would like to use, and I'm going to write the word loop. But before I loop, I'm going to take my int counter and I'm going to make it equal to int counter plus 1. And I can't forget to do that, otherwise I'm going to get stuck in an infinite loop. So I'm going to highlight this code here and I'm going to hit tab, because it'll be much more readable if I do that. I can see what's happening with this loop, and then I can see what's happening with this loop a little more easily. I'm also going to get rid of this 4, and on the outside of the double quotes, I'm going to type an ampersand and int counter so that my numbers will change. And then I'm going to delete the code below it that I had copied and pasted. I just did that so that you can see what we're actually looping through. So now this should loop through until my counter equals 10, which is going to be 6 times. So I'm going to Alt Tab back to Excel. I'm also going to add one question to each of these so that we can see the totals being updated when we run our code. So I'm going to scroll to the bottom of my data set, and I'm going to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to put Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, and Q6 as if I added new questions. And I'm going to put A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, and A6 as if I put new answers in. So now my macro should rerun. Let's look at these numbers right here. I'm going to put these off to the side so that we can watch the change. It's 23, 17, 14, and then 317. So let's just put that number right over here so we can make sure it changes, and left align those so that it's easier to see them. Okay, so let's go back to view, macros, and run our sort and recalculate macro. And you can see each one of these has incremented by 1, and my cursor is at the bottom of my entire data set. So if I scroll up, I can see Q5 under 5, Q4 under 4, Q3 under 3, Q2 under 2, and Q1 under 1. So we have used a double loop inside of this macro. I'm going to Alt Tab back to VBA so that you can see what I'm talking about. We have a loop on the outside right here that's looping through each one of those counters. And then we also have a loop on the inside, which is changing the value of the cell each time. So hopefully that makes sense to you. And look at how few lines of code we used to do all of that. I'm going to Alt Tab back to Excel. And if I go under my macros here and I go to view macros, I'm going to click on my sort and recalculate macro. And I'm going to go down here to options, and I'm going to hit control, and then I'm going to actually hit shift S. And what this will do is it will allow me to use control plus shift plus S to be able to run this macro. So I'm going to say okay, and I'm going to cancel out of here. Now, instead of constantly going to macros, run macro, I can hit control shift S on my keyboard and my macro will run automatically. So in review today, we learned how to use the offset function inside of VBA in order to total up the amount of values inside of each category inside of our spreadsheet. And we also learned how to assign keyboard keys to running a macro so that you don't have to keep going up to macro, run macro. Hopefully you learned something new today. We will be doing a few more lessons on different VBA routines that you can create to make your life easier in Excel. Hopefully we'll see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.